Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Tyranny. Last time we changed up the group a bit. Now we have Verse and Barrick back in, as well as myself and Eb. And what we're doing here, we are going heading over to Twin Rivers, because there's a lot of things basically dealing with the Bronze Brotherhood. You're going to find out that where a Forgebrand apprentice has gone missing. We're also going to find out, we got to kill a member of the Bronze Brotherhood to avenge Dea's wife, and basically we have to deal with the Bronze Brotherhood right now. We could head back to Lethe's Crossing to turn in a couple of quests, but it's easier for us now just to basically deal with the Bronze Brotherhood. So we're gonna go do that right now. Okay, so Twin Rivers is where we want. There's that one-off mission in Broken Plains. But that involves attacking the Disfavored. I really don't want to deal with that right now. Like, I do not want to attack the Disfavored in any way. I want to basically repair relations with them right now. Especially since, at the moment, evidence is heavily pointing towards Nerat starting off the Civil War. Okay, so Brother Salus, help us! Help before they kill us all! Flush with the fatigue and wide-eyed panic, a Brotherhood warrior bounds towards you, fleeing the signs of battle. Two arms! Calm yourself and explain. The Scourges! They swarmed us from every direction. The first brother, Retumen, he entered the Oldwalls, and shortly after the Bane swarmed us. He regains some composure and begins to speak more clearly. We've been cut off from base camp. Welby tried to maintain some sense of order, but after Retumen vanished and the Scourge appeared, the doors to the Oldwalls tickle shut. How can I unseal the door to the Oldwalls? Didn't you hear what I said? The Bane are attacking us. I don't care how to get inside right now. I have bigger problems to deal with. Shouldn't you be holding the line, not crying for help? Crying? How dare you? I'm rallying the flank. I'm certainly not a coward. This isn't the chance for childish banter. Please, we need your help. Then prove you're not a coward. Lead the charge and I'll follow. You would support the Brotherhood in this fight? Then victory might still be ours. Come on. I think you'll find few things bring folk together like a common threat. Without our help, they're probably doomed. With your help, they'll most likely live and maybe, just maybe, even thank us. Oh, who am I kidding? I'd wager my rings on Kopi's claims of, well, we would have won without you. It feels right to help a fellow soldier over a change. Make no mistake, he's a sellsword, but so few enjoy the privilege of fealty to Ash. Let's be off. Right, let's go and say hi to these people. We've got some scourges to deal with here. Right, we're in the middle? Yes, we are. Okay, so, let's start the battle. Start with a Rhyme Fireball. Can I hit both of them? Okay, I'll hit... That guy's already... Eh. I'll hit that guy. Okay, we'll cast Rhyme Fireball over there. you have all these new spells to be trying out as well. Electric Gel. You are weak to ice, so you can fire Rhyme Spike at this guy. You can do your taunting over here. And you can fire off your fire arrow at this guy. Right, slow-mo is active. We are now in combat. Okay, so Eb's... Did you miss Eb? Eb, you missed. That's a shame. Right, Eb, move forward a bit, because you need to basically hit the guy with that. It's unlikely that you'll hit, though, unfortunate. Okay, so we've got the Rhyme Fireball worked out. Twisting Flame. Kind of want to do that, because Twisting Flame, of course, is fire-based, and that only hits one of them. So we'll go with Fulmination. Move forward a little bit, go with a Fulmination. That'll hit both of them. I believe... Now, you're resistant to... Ice is the ideal thing, isn't it? Yes, ice would be the ideal thing. So, Twisting Flame... It would do that, then, because it'll hit one of them, at least. The thing's constantly disengaging and getting hit. So, No. Okay, immune to mage fire, immune to disarms, but that wisp is dead, which means you can now switch your electric jolt to that guy who should be relatively neutral to it. Which will help a little bit. Eb! What are your spells, Eb? You have a Path of Frost, don't you? Yes, you do. Eb, move. Move over there, Eb, and get like a better angle on this shot. The thing just died, okay. fire that way then. Okay, we're done, so we're gonna cast. We have so many spells to cast now. Searing Palm. Fulmination's back up, is it? So it is. Holy crap. Fire it this direction then. Go, Ebb. That's a nice ability. You fight well. Remind me to always stay on your side in the battlefield. By the Brotherhood, who knows how much worse that might have gotten without your help. I'm Brother Silas. I apologize. There wasn't much time for... It may be Kalus, from Kalum, which means, like, heavens and stuff. I apologize there isn't much time for introductions earlier. On behalf of the Bronze Brotherhood, I welcome you to Twin Rivers. I can only assume you are here for Raytomon. What happened here? What are Raytomon's plans for Lethian's Crossing? I wish I knew. Raytomon said he was going to carry out the next part of his plan. He unsealed the door and went inside with some of our brothers. A few minutes later, the Bane came out pouring out of the entrance and overwhelmed us. I saw Raytomon standing at the entrance wearing a strange helmet. He was smiling. He was watched the Bane overwhelm us and he was smiling. Then the doors closed and I became a little bit more occupied with staying alive. I need to get inside the old walls. Can you point me to the entrance? The entrance is to the north, but the bridge is out. Damn scourges are more wily than they let on. Unless you want to jump across the river, you'll have to go around. You won't have much luck getting inside since Raytomon sealed the entrance behind him. Welby may be able to help you, though. She was trying to rally my brothers northeast of here. Okay, right, so we killed everything that needed dying. You could grab everybody in. Right.
Time to lighten my step.
There's something down here. Here we go. I knew there was something down here.
Can't do that.
Ooh, and I'm assuming that I need athletics to push that branch out the way. Yep, we're through the bush. Yep, we're through here now. You can at least access this, I suppose. Tangle Root Braid. Plus 1% health every 6 seconds. I'll put that there. We'll see who needs that. Actually, who can use that? Who's got a spare slot? Because you've got Frozen Burst and Parrying. You've got Purifying, which is immunity to poisoned, and Blood of the Fallen. Of Rogues and of Form. You've got Regenerating and Haste. Technically, you probably could do with Regenerating. Frozen Burst, yeah, go on. Get Regenerating on. Get some Regeneration on there. Okay, we're so far so good. 7, 8, 9. We'll put you there then. Skycap. Sure, get some Skycap just in case you ever need it. Telsetany goes over there. Okay. Fine and dandy, we'll work our way back. And keep pushing onwards. Okay. Right, so I'm assuming that is... Yeah. I'm assuming we got something there. Evidence against forces in right. See, the evidence against voices in right is massive, but I'm assuming that's because I haven't been speaking to the Disfavored. I assume the Disfavored will have more to say about them, of that matter. The river flows from Lethian's Crossing to this point where it splits into what are known as the Twin Rivers. Can I repair the bridge? Or can I jump it over? The destroyed bridge. I can ford the river with 49 athletics. Which I've got, so it's not a problem.
Can't do that. Sorry, I can't.
We can...
Can't do that.
We can't go around, you say. Unless there's something on the main map that means I can go around? There may be something on the main map that I can go around. I'm not going to go around, I'm going to ford, I think, if it's too much of a problem. No, I'm going to go around. I'm going to go stay here, there's no point. Yeah, we'll just back out and... We can just... If you can just go around... What did he mean by going around? Did he mean we can cross over here? Okay, we can cross over there, so let's do this. If you can cross over here, we're going to cross over here, just so we can explore more of the map, you know? Okay, there's some scourges over there. A lot of scourges over there, actually. What have we actually got here? We've got a Malice, which is vulnerable to lightning. A Wisp, which is strong against lightning. Great. And so you're strong against fire, you're strong against cold, you're strong... What is that one? That one is Aura of Malice. Oh, okay, you need to die then. You definitely need to die. Aura of Rage... That's fine. So yeah, you definitely need to die simply because they want to focus on lightning spells against you. That's the general idea. Anyway, boop. Right. Grab everyone you can. Like, grab... Hang on. Move forward a little bit further. Great. Grab everyone. Grab... Ban everyone. You... Straight fire... Into there. Straight up, go there. You both... Electric jolts need to happen there. And... There. Like, that thing needs to die quickly because he's gonna start stripping positive buffs. Okay, that's useful. Can we just do for... Can go for a Path of Frost. It'll hit a lot of people. Yeah, do it. Now, what does Path of Frost actually affect? It's against versus dodge. The dodge of a Scourge is actually quite high. That's why it can't hit. Whereas the Wisp have a really low dodge but a really high will defense. Inconvenient, but there you have it. We'll do Twisting Flame in the same manner. We're going to do Twisting Flame. Verse just did a thing. Verse stopped. That goes from it. Yeah. Like, it'll take a while, but it's more important that these things all die, to be honest. Do you get hit? I don't think you actually get hit. I don't think that's actually what that means. You hit that. Eb just finished her ability as well, so... Eb can cast, that. Right, good. A lot of damage has happened here, which is very, very nice. I'm liking that, basically, you've got to a stage where... Oh, hello. What do you trick? You go against... Versus magic defense. Which is really good against these guys. Their magic defense is very, very low indeed. Like 18. Their magic defense is very low. What about your spells? Concussive Bolt. Phantom Bolt versus magic. So that should work out nicely as well. So actually, no. Use, what is it called? Grave Strike. That's versus magic. Oh, nicely done, Eb, and Fulmination should finish the other two off. Not quite, but close enough. Ooh, you go for a heal there. Clever. Let's go for some heals then. Go for Vital Body. Get some regeneration going on Barrack. Ah, Jesus. Spell Breach, that's not great. Spell Breach, I think you take extra damage from spells. Yeah, you lose armor against energy. Put Vital Body there. Have you got Vital Body, okay. You are casting a spell. Okay, Vital Body's worked out there, so you're regenerating now, although you're now wounded, unfortunately. Barrack, finish casting that spell, then move in. Go ahead and just do Charged Fist, and you can go ahead and use Electric Jolt. Like, that thing's weak to lightning. Shit. Jesus. Cast it. Good. That's something, at least. It's not a lot, to be honest, but it's something. You need to go over there and... Okay, it's stunned, at least, but... You're on the lowest of low healths. Yeah. Get a potion up there. You need a potion. Barrack, can you taunt? Barrack, please. Okay, Barrack, you've taunted, so hopefully... Misses. Great. Right, can you keep on doing these things? Electric jolts.
I got it.
That thing is not good. Stunned, brilliant. Right, so you can cast. What are your healing spells? You got Restoring Touch. Cast Restoring Touch.
Did I always have?
No. Hang on. You. What are your healing spells like? Vital Body. Which you've already used, unfortunately. You are neutral to fire, so might as well use the Grime Fireball, which is one of our best spells. Target destroyed. Okay, well, that worked out. That took a while to get done. Okay. How much regeneration are you getting? You're getting... That's down... That's... Again, so how much does that actually do? If I cast Vital Body... It's got a long cooldown. Alright, so what do we got here? We have ourselves a Bronze Brotherhood Axe, which is broken. Here we go. Some Bane Essence. Bane Essence basically does increased Arcane Armor. Mace. Bronze Brotherhood Axe is... pretty much exactly the same as when you've got... You increase DPS but lower recovery and accuracy. No, okay, we'll go back to that. Okay, then we go up for a bit, get these guys. A Maul Warhammer, pretty much a Maul. And Potions of Insight. Swig of Insight, defense against spells and will defense. Okay.
I'll be your shadow.
Do you have eyes on this?
Yes, I do. And a trap detected as well. What do you have here? We have Waking Death, Sable Root, Blood Moss.
Let's try not to stand out, shall we?
Okay, so disarm that. Go verse.
I'll stay down.
Technically, you're the strongest person among us with respect to subterfuge, although I'm not sure if that's true anymore. My subterfuge is 83, yours is 64. Now, I'm the best at everything. I'm the best. I'm better at parry. You are really good at parry. You don't have a Spire Rest bonus. Oh. Right. There's a trap right there. Yeah, I'm gonna say I can see the damn trap. Good.
It'll take more than that.
Right, let's get start getting some castings out. Start doing that. Rhyme Fireball on the center one. And you can go ahead and cast Arcane Missile on one of them. You can go ahead and cast... there you go. Start casting the things that need casting, guys. You use your ability. Go over there and use your ability, dammit. Rhyme Fireball as well, what the hell? Cast it. Rhyme Fireball's gone. You can cast... that. You're casting Phantom Bolt against something. Okay, you can cast... Vital Body on you, you can cast Vital Body on you. Let's get those up and running. They last a while anyway. Right. Move over there. You can join in. Go fire a charged fist over there. You... go over there. And Ebb. Fire an Arcane Missile.
Oops. Nope.
That thing
Sorry.
Just died as well. Fatebinder, I would talk to you. Would you, indeed? I may not wish to. Bronze bracers, that's not happening. There's only one person in my army, in my group, that uses heavy armor, and he's locked inside his own head.
Be subtle?
Okay, right. What do we have here? Alchemy supplies and a bronze ingot. Some cheese. Some cheese, fish. Doors are closed, but we're going to go through and basically grab everything we can. Staggering Burn, I think you can use Staggering Burn. Not that I use items, I should be using items more.
Found something.
Some iron ingots. Bronze throwing daggers. Again, you lose everything, but... Bronze Throwing Daggers probably is something more designed for Lantry. Because Lantry has the Quill weapon. I can move back. Who's the person who needs to be? I need to be killing somebody. Welby. Oh, Welby was the person we met before, wasn't it? Yeah, Welby was the person, who, the sub-leader that was vaguely sensible.
Sorry, I can't.
Can you go up here and... You can climb up there temporarily. I'm assuming there's... Ah, Sandro. Right, we'll talk to Welby first, because I don't think how Welby's going to be happy when we kill Sandro. We'll talk to Welby first. I was hoping to see you again, Fatebinder. You picked the perfect time to show your face. Well, we've actually sort of roughly matched our favor and wrath. Normally, I would ask you to explain yourself. Indiscriminately attacking those with different views from yours is a sign of a small mind, but in light of recent events, I'm inclined to agree with your methods. You were here for Ray Tommen, aren't you? I won't waste my time. He's gone, as is the keystone you'll need to get him. That half-wit brute Myrick took it to Deserter's Watch. He went to gather more support for Ray Tommen's maddening plot. The brothers out here are outraged by Ray Tommen's betrayal. He's gone crazier than a candle mountain miner. So if you're here to help, we'll take any help we can get that keystone back from Deserter's March. I've got my hands full here. Is there anything I can do to help you? What is Ray Tommen hoping to accomplish here? His growing mania with the Bane has exploded into an obsession. I think he's planning on using them to purge Lethian's Crossing of all the unworthy. She points emphatically at the old walls as she speaks. The problem is, the Bane know nothing of worth. All they know is death and chaos. If Ray Tommen is allowed to go through this, Lethian's Crossing will be destroyed. Do you have any idea what I might say to Ray Tommen to convince him to stand down? I have no clue, Fatebinder. I have repeatedly tried to talk him out of this insane plot, and nothing I say gets through. Maybe he will listen to someone who isn't so close to him. He responds mostly to flattery lately. Maybe you can butter him up. I've got the keystone. That is wonderful news. Unfortunately, that is only the first puddle of Beastman piss you'll have to deal with. You must get inside the old walls and confront Ray Tommen. She winces and doubles over briefly. I'm not going to be able to go with you, Fatebinder. I'm in no condition to fight right now. I have no doubt you'll be able to handle yourself in there. Good luck. Good. Let's go in there and basically kill Sandro. Well, we are charged with murdering Sandro to avenge Phaedra. Hello, level up. We just walked to... Okay, you just leveled up. I'll take that. Take the cooldown. Take the accuracy as well, I think. I'm going to balance out accuracy and cooldowns with you. But you're also going to get Skirmisher. Because we got... We're carrying on with Duelist, aren't we? Because we got Evasive last time, so we're going to get Skirmisher. Blade Dancer is probably what we want. Blade Dancer is probably what we want. Increases weapon damage by 15% while dual wielding. So that's probably what we need. Cool. Use that. And that's fine. Okay, cool. Let's talk to... let's open this up. What do you have here? A bronze chattel. It's a one-handed... sword, I guess, but should go through armor. The whole point of the chattel is that it's designed to like bend around shields, isn't it? As far as I'm aware, the chattel is like a curved blade that's designed to spread or hit around shields. It's way less accurate, like stupidly less accurate. Holy moly! I guess because it's not a dagger. A dagger has it's this increased DPS. Yes, it's curved to hit around a shield. You can hit like around somebody's shield. That really isn't... I think that's reflected by the fact that it has Pierce as a damage type, which is technically stronger against people with armor. I'm going to put that for you, because you might make use of that. Actually, how are we doing? Yeah, you can go. You guys can go in there. What do you have? We got ourselves the Agent's Reports, the Forgebound Sip, and the Crude Map. Key Walls, Old Stone. Mysterious Missive, Incomplete Charcoal Rubbing. And Old from Iron Guard, Ventera. Do you want to put that in? Because it's superior. So, if we did that... You know what? We're going to do that. We're going to have a bit more damage on your offhand. That's a little bit more cooldown, but a little bit more damage on your offhand. In case that needs to happen. Scarlet Chorus Leather Armor. Okay, fine. Right. Stay back. I'm armed. Clad in piecemeal leathers, the sweaty man seizes you up, relaxing slightly as he reads your gestures. Leave me be, please. I'm sick and wish to be left alone. I don't wait to speak to anyone right now. You seem nervous, not ill. Indeed I am. I can't stomach it anymore. I thought I'd get used to seeing people die, but the Brotherhood and their raids, there's just no end in sight. I want to be away from the folk of the crossing right now. You seem somewhat oddly dressed for a Brotherhood mercenary. Oh, this? I'm not actually a Brotherhood soldier. It was the only way I could use to get out of Lethian's Crossing alive. Dea was trying to find me. I thought it best to disguise myself as a Brotherhood sellsword and follow them. I found a dead brother and donned some of his armor. I didn't really have time to figure out how to put it all on, but it all worked well enough to get me here. I know you killed Dea's wife. What? You must be joking. I would never... His mouth moves, but no words form as he steps back away. It's a lie. You may be right. She didn't seem overly happy with Phaedra when I was... No. Just tell me what you did, Sandro. I swear I won't tell anyone. Make Kyros strike me down if I'm lying. I didn't kill Phaedra. She did. It was Dea. Dea said that you were with the Brotherhood and you killed Phaedra. She said, what? The Brotherhood? Absolutely not. Do I look like I can even lift an axe without hurting myself? I saw Dea kill Phaedra. She killed her own wife and blamed that motherless trollop as trying to frame me. Why would Dea kill her own wife? How should I know? Dea was never very happy with her, and she wasn't happy that Phaedra and I were friends. Phaedra should have married her. I told Phaedra it was a bad idea, but she wouldn't listen, and now she's dead. If you and Phaedra were friends, why would Dea frame you? Because I told Phaedra not to marry Dea, and she always hated me for that. Phaedra and I have been childhood friends since childhood. We promised to always be honest to each other, even when it hurts. When Phaedra left to live in the Bastard City, I stayed in Lethian's Crossing to keep an eye on things for her. Then Phaedra told me she'd fallen in love. I was initially happy for her, but when she brought Bea back to Lethian's Crossing to meet me, I could see right away that Dea wasn't interested in Phaedra aside from what Phaedra could offer her. If you're lying by omission, I will personally toss you into the dungeons of the Bastard City. Please have mercy. You see, Phaedra, well, she was Lethian's granddaughter. As Lethian's only known female heir, she inherited the land that Lethian's Crossing sits on, but she didn't like to make a fuss about it. She just did what it was needed to ensure the future of the town and left it at that. Dea, on the other hand, wanted more. I think she taxed the merchants till near their breaking point if she was able. How can you be sure that's what Dea wanted? Dea was always pushing Phaedra to increase the number of rings they collected from merchants. Fortunately, Phaedra wouldn't have it. She loved Lethian's Crossing and refused to manipulate its people for her own gain. And why should I believe any of this? I don't have any proof. All I can do is trust that, as Fatebinder, you'll know what I'm saying is true. Why are you wearing Phaedra's necklace? This? It's mine. Phaedra bought it for me in Arden 10 years ago. Did Dea tell you that this was Phaedra's necklace? That's absurd. This necklace is a symbol of friendship that Phaedra and I had. Give me the necklace. I wish to fool Dea. She lies about me now I should lose my necklace? The one that Phaedra gave me? Fine, take it. If it brings Dea to justice, then it's worth the price. Don't leave here, buddy.
On it.
If I find out you're lying to me, you will die. But if Dea is lying, then she will die. Someone's gonna die over this, and it's not going to be me. Addendum added, a widow's revenge. You retrieve the necklace. You learned the truth about Dea. Okay, so fair enough. So it is... Thanks, game. You're not gonna let it play any more subtly than that. It's like, nope, that's the truth. Okay. No subtleties. Use the keystone. Right, let's go inside. And stop this madness. This madness. Okay, so who do we have here? Flatfoot Ferris. I'm assuming you want to talk, Flatfoot. I'm assuming you're loyal because you're alive. The Brotherhood soldier eyes you with immediate distrust, holding up a hand, indicating you should stop. How in the name of my fallen brothers did you get in here? There are other ways past the doors, and I know them all. Merrick gave me the keystone. So what happened to Merrick if you have the keystone? Why isn't he with you? Well, there was an altercation between some of your brothers and Merrick didn't survive. Brothers fighting brothers. We have bigger problems and you shouldn't be killing each other. Suppose it's the price we pay, but that doesn't explain why you're here. Tell me what you want or get gone. What's happened here? After we got here, Ray Tommen went on ahead. He said he had something he needed to do. We heard this terrible noise and suddenly we were swarmed by scourges. They looked like they were running away from something. It was crazy. I've never seen him act like that way before. Some of them attacked us, but most of them kept going right out the door. Then Ray Tommen reappeared and the rest of the scourges just up and left. Ray Tommen was laughing, almost like it was a game. He was saying, this will show them, this is just a taste. Then he sealed the doors and told me not to let anyone else through. What is the Brotherhood doing inside the old walls? I don't see how that's any of your business, really, but I suppose I don't see how it would hurt to tell you since you're already here. Ever since Ray Tommen spent a night inside to prove he was worthy to be the first brother, he spent more and more time in here. He said he mapped out the path so he can get through without attracting the Bane, and we've never had a problem as long as we stayed in this room. We can hide out and no one knows we're here. You're the first one I've seen in here who wasn't part of the Brotherhood. He told me to stay here and gave me something he calls a torch key. I have no idea what it is or what it's for, what it does, and Ray Tommen didn't tell me. He keeps his secrets to himself. I need your help to find the Forgebound Master Zedenya. You're funny, Fatebinder. Ray Tommen told me that you can't be trusted to keep you from getting through at all costs, so unless you're suddenly changed loyalties and you're planning on swearing fealty to Ray Tommen, you're not getting past me. Let's talk about something else. Give me that torch key. Mind if I do the talking? I think I know what he needs to hear. If you think you can get it from him, go ahead and try. Young man! Ebb steps forward with a smile and plants her staff in the ground with a conspicuous thud. How long can you hold your breath? With one hand on her staff, the other begins to trace a pattern in the air. How long can I... Listen, Snowflake, I don't have time for your stupid... His words come to a choking halt as he grips his throat, retching a trickle of water from his nose and mouth. He falls to one knee, steadying himself as he gasps for air. Because I'd wager you all my rings for your torch key that you can't handle more than 2 minutes of this? I'm certainly happy to find out for sure. Ebb signs another gesture to the air, halting the drowning spell. No more, take it! Ferris throws the torch key to the ground as he spits and hacks his lungs clear. Dirty water witch! Nicely done. Tell me what you want to get gone. I'll be back. Okay. Okay, so will he let us through? Genuinely not sure.
You see what I see?
What do you have here? Ooh, ethereal. Plus 50% graze deflection. Okay, we'll put that there. Ooh. Who gets to make the most out of the ethereal stuff? That's... Right, probably one of you guys. Haste gives you what? Plus 1 to quickness. Yeah, go for the ethereal deflection. Right, can we, like, hide? You said something, buddy. I didn't hear what it was. Nope. Okay, you said something out loud. Anything here? Yes. Achievement unlocked. Perceptive. Hide. Aquamarine. Water. Good. You got all that goodness. Alright, will he let us pass? That's the key question. Will he let us go up here? Okay, there's something over there. Let's go say hi over here. Camping supplies. I guess we can't grab those. We're full of camping supplies as it is. I was going to camp to basically heal Verse, but she leveled up, which healed everything. The crystal in the beacon shimmers softly as you bring it close to the torch key closer to it. Touch the beacon with the Ameth torch key. A rune on the floor, because why else would they put runes there? Okay, so we've opened up some stuff. Okay, so it's clearly kind of puzzle. Can I just... If he just lets us walk through, we just... Okay. Can you open all the doors? Okay, we'll work our way through then. Hey, if he lets us through, he lets us through.
Would you take a look at that?
What's this? This is some whetstone.
Sorry, I can't.
This is some more whetstone. Okay. Nothing in there. I'm assuming that thing could be opened normally, and basically we need the torch key to open this one. I haven't got the correct torch key. Yeah. What's this? This is the healing potion. Okay, we'll put that over there as well. Okay, what do we have here? Some more alchemy supplies and stuff. Okie dokie.
Sorry.
So I'm assuming we need a different... Yeah, we need a different torch key from a different place. Like, the Ameth torch key looks like that, essentially. Okay. Like, definitely this place. This definitely lit up with the torch key, so...
Sorry, I can't. Can't do that.
So what's over here? Let's have a look around. Trap detected, huh? Look at this. Just disarm things. Barrack. I like that you share the skills. It's useful. Ah. Okay. We got some scourges now. Kill right, that. Fine. All nation can hit everyone? Yeah, we can. You're there in the right place as well. You can go straight into a grave light and hit these guys that because... Okay, you've just done that one. Go for a... That. Okay, good. Then you can go for a... 85, but go for that. Get that dervish down, because those dervishes hurt. Quite a bit, actually. Who's doing what right now? Taunt everybody, because in case people start to move, you should be fine and dandy with that. Okay, you get to cast Electric Jolt on this thing. You need to cast Rhyme Ball here. Barrack is leveled up. That thing just died. So, who's doing what right now? Ebb, cast the Tidal Burst on this thing, push it away from you. While I'll basically cast an Electric Jolt on it to make sure. No, it's resistant. I'll cast Searing Palm on it to make sure. Oh, didn't quite work. Is that a graze? It was a graze. Okay. Ebb, can you please, like, just keep moving? A lot of healing spells going on off over here. A lot of healing spells going off. What can we do? We can cast Electric Jolt on Wisp. It's going to be immune anyway, so might as well cast it there because it'll hit both of them. Okay, you can cast not Fulmination, Charge Fist. Ebb, Restoring Touch, you.
Oh, that one fucking hurt.
You're in low health, buddy. Right, cast Vital Body. Get those casts out and over and done with.
Will do. Tear your skeleton out. Good. By your ass.
That worked out well for us. Good. A little bit of regen happening over here. That door opened at least. There's something in this room over here. And what's the way into this room? Stairs over there. So do I not want to go this way?
I got it.
Okay. Hang on. So there's something over. There's something over here. Locked subterfuge.
Fall on the reflexes.
Heavy armor. Can you please stop with the bait with the heavy armor stuff? Sigil of Terratus. Control Gravelight. Actually useful for you. You're gonna have to go heavy armor on your gloves because of that. That Sigil of Terratus is gonna be very useful for you. What is that? That's just regular nobleman's bracers. Yeah. Okay. So, there's a need to get in there, but it's not going to be at the moment. Hello. Brackish and foul-smelling water pours from these spouts and disappearing into nothingness. Okay. Oh, and, okay, you leveled up, didn't you? Yes, you did. Um, Okay, what are you? Sentinel still. So what's the choices here? You can put 6 points. It's Defender's Watch, Heroic Defense. Once per combat, you'll get 38 health. Okay, that's not too bad. Bond of Honor. Defender's Charge. Leap to the aid of an ally, taunting enemies nearby. Go for Heroic Defense to start off with. Then we'll get Defender's Charge, definitely. Hang on, did something drop? Something dropped. Quickly head back for the time being, just to see what it's like. Let's quickly head back so we can get that basically dropped open. It's gonna be like, yeah, it's gonna be an arcane essence. I knew that, but still. Worth it. So what's your power? Your dodge is 76. Your dodge is actually higher. How is your dodge higher than versus? That just seems... Your dodge is shield modifier to dodge. Okay, you got red guys, that's why. So you should be actually on 76, on 686. In fact, if you go for three whispers, dodge 106. Yeah, fair enough. Okay, so hang on. Huh, interesting. What's the situation here then? How do we get up there? That is the thing over there. That is closed off to us. Like, I'm assuming there's a door over there, but it's blocked by whatever these massive rocks are, so, well. We'll keep going for now. Maybe we'll find something else. Maybe Ray Tommen has a different torch key or something. Corpse, the torn piece of parchment, and a citron torch key. Okay, we got a citron torch key. This piece of parchment displays the sigils of the old world's torch keys. Okay, so hang on, does that show us anything? This torn piece of parchment has a crudely drawn rose sigil in the center. And... now I want to go back and check, dammit. Now I want to go back and check if it's the correct torch key. I genuinely don't know. Head back to here. Because if it's over there, we'll head basically... that's the old wall's beak, fine. See if it's that torch key we just got. Sadly, like, there's no way to look at the torch key symbols. Unfortunately. As long as if I can tell by color either, because the color only appears after you use the torch key. No, it's not that torch key, damn it. Okay, so it's not that torch key. What's the... finely, crudely drawn rose sigil. What does a rose sigil even look like? Almost level 9. Ebb's almost level 9. I think max level is something like 20. Or is it like 15 or something? I can't remember. Okay, so let's do that there. Case. Oh, brilliant. That's useful. So citron. So that doesn't work. Oh, it does work. That works? How interesting. I've got control of two doors. That is cool.
Sorry, I can't.
Right, there's some scourge in there then.
This will be fun.
Okay, Barrack. Get a taunt off. Oh dear, that's not great, is it? No, it's not a great position to be in. Grave strike, hit everybody. Rhyme fireball. Go. Jesus. Look at that. I think it's the scourges. They're the ones that really, really hurt. Gravestrike is still going, which is useful because you're going to need the health back from that. And a level up, so that's exactly what you needed in terms of... Okay, can you... What's the one problem I have with giving Barak's spells is that he goes in the middle of combat, he's like, you know what you need to do is cast a healing spell. Like, no you don't, stop casting healing spells. You do not need to cast healing spells unless I tell you to do so. We need to cast... Phantom Bolt. You need to cast... that, essentially. Cast that. Okay, that worked well enough. Fulmination. That'll hit everyone. That guy's invulnerable to the lightning bolt, but it's not too much of a problem. You've got Rhyme Spike. Which will work there, I suppose. Okay, still ongoing. Good.
I'll tear your skeleton out by your ass.
Heal yourself up, Ed. Good. Get some damage on this malice here. I'm gonna start casting. I need lightning for this guy, right? Yeah, I need lightning. So I'm gonna start casting electric jolt. You're gonna start casting electric jolt. You can cast your fire arrow. Stunned and burning. Double stunned. Electric fist. Ball lightning.
Will do.
Doesn't matter, died anyway.
Fall before me.
Ball lightning. Bazap, 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 bazap. One of the mercenaries stepped forward, struggling to stand. Whoever you are, thank you. We had better chances when our number were greater, but things began to descend once the Nabane ambushed us. You're welcome. Did Ray Tommen send you to rescue us? Ray Tommen had never had any intention of coming back for you. I'm sorry. A streak of anger flashed across his face before it quickly subsides to despair as the truth sets in. We had our doubts when we entered the Old Walls, and only a handful of Brotherhood were even given torch keys. As you can tell, we were not among them. We'll be heading back to camp. We've had enough of this whole day. Ray Tommen can rot in here for all I care. They currently like us more than they hate us. Which is not bad. Brotherhood of Favorability, Mighty Blows, hello! Alright, you got, get your spell strength up to scratch. You get Gravelight. We got that one, which is the one we wanted, really. So what else can we move here? Runic Barrier gives you even more armor. Spell Barrier gives you a bonus of spell defenses. Ebb's presence frightens near my Bane. Interesting. We are fighting a lot of Bane now, so that's not too bad of a situation to be in. Alternatively, plus 20 to Gravelight. Gravelight is doing a lot of damage here at the moment, so... keep moving that. Like, that's genuinely useful, whereas... Guess what is... it's a passive aura of 3% melee damage. Okay, that's not too bad.
Look at that, future corpse.
Okay. Barak, taunt the guy, please. Wow. This is in slow mode? Holy golly, this is fast. Okay, let's get some things done. Let's get some stuff done out fast. You're still hurt, so Grave Strike will do. You can go ahead and cast Electric Jolt. Well, Fulmination will do the trick as well. You got Healing Wisps to cast on somebody. You cast it on yourself. Might as well cast...
You got it. You learn something every day.
The Shriek is happening over there. Fine, level up. Ah, sweet, we leveled up as well. Nice. So we got 1 point there. Let's work on getting our accuracy up then. And leadership points. While in combat, your party members in a fight near you get an additional, get more points. Second wind. Once per combat, when you fall to low health, you can let out a battle cry that heals you and your party members for a portion of their maximum health. It doesn't say, there's nothing in second wind that adds, that has the when you fall to low health bit. Seize initiative is stealth based. Abundant arms is that. Second wind. We'll see how second wind works out. Just cast like a lightning blast. You can't do fulmination. We'll cast vital body on you. Right, what can you do? You can cast a phantom bolt. I'll hit both of them. Okay, and then what can you do? You haven't got... Okay, so... At what point can you use that? Once per combat. I guess because I leveled it in combat, it doesn't count. They didn't give it the spell, which is fair enough, I suppose. Electric Jolt. Oof, and... Nicely done. And everyone just go in and kill the thing. He just did something. Can you kill it? Thank you. Thank you, Ab. Oh, Jesus. Come on, can you please? Right, okay. Right, so that's there. You are weak to ice damage, so we're going to put a... Wow, you got really high dodge, haven't you? It's really annoying having to hit you with anything useful. We're going to cast... That. You were gonna cast that. You're stunned at least, it helps out a bit. You're gonna cast Fulmination. No, it's Fulmination? Fulmination. You're gonna cast. Yeah, cast that. Cast that ice rime wall, or whatever it's called. That works over there, and you guys can just carry on and start doing attacks over here. Barak annihilated the wisp. We're gonna get a... Come on, I'm just waiting for that one to trigger. It didn't trigger. Interesting. Right.
Oh, my hairpin. Oh, sure. The lock's open.
Knew it.
What cost?
Barak. Okay, so what's the situation here? Okay, wait, hold the phone. That guy needs to die, right? And you're vulnerable to ice damage, so we're gonna hit a Raiden Fireball on your face. Still difficult to do. God. We're gonna get the Fireball running this way. And you are vulnerable to fire damage. So we're just gonna get, we're gonna get, like, ice walls and stuff heading this way. No, screw it. Let's carry on. Just do that, I think.
Come on.
You need to mage fire, but, Oh, you're fire. Why did I even try to do that? That's me being very, very silly. Um, Well, that's what is that? That is Aura of Rage, Frozen. Okay. Okay, right, you. Hit everybody. You can get your hands on. You. Flash Fire can hit everybody, except the fire person's not going to do much use against you, but that's fine. You. Barak.
Let's have it then.
A lot of damage happened there. A lot of damage happened there. Ebb. Keep hitting this guy with Grave Light. Right. Electric Jolt.
Will do.
On Mr. Fireball over there. Ebb. Let's focus on getting some. You can get some ice damage on you, right? Yeah. It's not going to be great, but it's something. Keep Barracks down, which means you need to change targets. Iron Storm. Okay, Iron Storm involves me moving over here. Then I can Iron Storm, I think, right? At that point I can Iron Storm? Iron Storm. Iron Storm! Swords fly out! Iron Storm is such a cool ability. Well, actually, what other combo builds have we got? We got Iron Storm, we've got Iron Tolling. We have Terratus' Embrace, which is a mega heal. And Light of the Grave. Bloodsoak Stone. Yeah, we could do Bloodsoak Stone, but there's no real point in doing that. We'll just hit you with a Rhyme Fireball. Boom! Okay, that was the Wisp hitting. Okay, right. Oh, the Wisp exploded. I think that was literally what happened. I get the feeling that the Wisp exploded. Maybe the Wisp didn't explode. Maybe that's just me. But I got the feeling that the Wisp exploded. What's that? This piece of parchment depicts the sigils of the old key of the old walls. Which means we have our second one now. Row. Actually, didn't pick it up today. It's row. Combined with the first parchment, you can see the crudely drawn row sigil in the center and a crudely drawn citron sigil in the upper left-hand corner. A part of a third sigil can be seen in the adjacent corner, obscured by blood. Okay, so what's the situation here? Citron opens that up. Good. What does Amrit do? Nothing. Amrit does that, though. Okay. Trap detected. Fair enough.
See what I see?
Go on, Barak, disarm that. Okay. Another trap. Verse can deal with that one. That opens that door. Apprentice Garrick.
Found something.
What do you have here? Cairn's Leaf, Fatiguing Toxin, Hide, and Alchemical Supplies. Okay. The bloody, dirt-smeared man cries out when he sees you. Thank the Forge Tender you found me. We have to get out of here before the Scourges come back, or the Brotherhood. I'm not sure which cares me more. You must be Apprentice Garrick. Oh yeah, you're one of the Forge Bound. Didn't Master Lohara mention me? So, at least she's noticed her apprentice's absence. I could have predicted that. I couldn't have come out here in the first place. I was searching in the area near the old walls entrance for unique materials or runes I could use in my crafting. I'm trying to advance to the next level of my apprenticeship. Impressing forge masters is much harder than it sounds, and Master Lohara is especially demanding. You really need to stand out, and I thought that this was my chance. I didn't even know the Bronze Brotherhood were here until some of them showed up. I grabbed a discarded helmet and I tried to blend in as till I could get away. The leader thought I was a soldier who got stuck away from his post, so he demanded that I return to my duties. I was scared, so I followed my orders and went inside. As soon as I could get out of sight, I started running toward trying to find a way out. There's supposed to be a path to Lethian's crossing somewhere. That could just be a story. Of course, I got turned around and couldn't find my way back. I barricaded myself in here to keep away from the Bronze Brotherhood patrols and scourges roaming around. If you hadn't shown up, it would only have been a matter of time before something found me. Don't you know it's illegal to trespass in the old walls? Why not disguise yourself? He knows it's illegal, for God's sake. Why not disguise yourself and sneak out? I would have, but I was committed to finding the connection with Lethian's crossing and left behind the Brotherhood armor I found. It was ill-fitting and noisy, and it didn't help to me evade the Bane, which I can assure you is far more pressing concern this far into the old walls than some hot-headed thugs. But you're right, the disguise is the better choice. It wasn't smart of me to let go of it, I know. And haven't been thinking straight. It's been a moment-to-moment struggle just to stay alive in this cursed place. I'm not sure you can find the gear I left behind, but I have heard the Brotherhood running through these halls. I'm certain there must be at least one of here around it that isn't in need of his armor anymore. With it, I believe I can make my way out. Okay, so find Garrick a Bronze Brotherhood armor. Don't you know it's illegal to trespass in the old walls? I know it doesn't look good, but I was hoping that someone would look the other way, since I'm doing it all for the sake of my work. I'm pretty sure that some of the disfavored garrison saw me leaving, but no one stopped me. That's as good as permission, right? I find you guilty of breaking Kyros' law! Like, no, for God's sake. I saw him leaving, I guess, but I'm in the Old Wars too. Let's keep this a secret between us. Sometimes I forget that you Fatebinders are beholden to Kyros' law. Of course, if I get out of here, I won't mention it to anyone. What can you tell me about Master Lohara? She's strict, but she makes sure I get things done quickly and efficiently. And like I said, she's also impossible to impress. I figured if I could get something in here to enhance my work, she'd have to notice me. Senpai. Now all I'm going to get is a lecture. That is, if I get out of here alive. I think, if I remember correctly, before I end today, it was something about, if he's dead, I need to get his tools. Yeah, I think the point of the tools thing is, if he's dead, I need to get his tools. Maybe. Anyway, I'm going to call it here for now, folks. As you might know, a new version of Star Sector is out, so a lot of my time is now taken up by that. And eventually, we shall do something about it. Anyway, I'll catch you guys next time, folks. See you then. Bye.